or zigzag or pointed 12. These 12s can be produced by reversing.
This video is audible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Video or Zoom Corona.
Yes, it is visible and audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so watch it and listen it and try to note down the queries.
The direction of the regular 12 at suitable intervals.
These 12s are produced by reversing the direction of the regular 12 at suitable intervals or at suitable points. So we are producing this modification by reversing the direction of 12 at a particular point. You know, because the 12 runs from left to right or right to left, then if we turn the direction, it will result in a modification. And because here the reversal is taking place on a particular point, so these 12s are producing a sharp point in the fabric, and that's why these are also termed as pointed 12s.
Reversal can occur either upon a warp, that is end, or upon a peak. If reversal is taking place on an end, a horizontal effect, or if it is reversing on a peak, a vertical effect will be produced.
Depending on the reversal, हम reversal कहाँ कर रहे हैं? एक end पर कर रहे हैं या peak पर कर रहे हैं? अगर हम end पर कर रहे हैं तो horizontal wave effect produce होंगे, और अगर हम peak पर कर रहे हैं तो vertical wave effect produce होंगे.
The horizontal wave effects are economically produced with pointed drafts on a few hills by means of 12 tappets. The vertical wave effects mostly require a Dobie shedding motion because of large number of peaks in the lifting plan. Now, first we decide the size. How we decide the size for a waved or zigzag or pointed 12? It is decided for, particularly we are taking for horizontal. So EPR means ends per repeat can be decided by taking a formula, that is 2N minus 2, and PPR can be decided by taking equal to N. And what is N here? N is number of hills required for base 12. Base 12 means the regular 12 which we are taking as the base. So for example, we are taking 2 up 2 down 12 is the base. So here, what is N? N will be equal to 4. So if N is 4, to produce horizontal effect, your EPR will be 2 into 4 minus 2, that is 6, and PPR will be equal to 4. The size for 2 up to down 12 will be 6 cross 4 if we have to produce horizontal effect. And if
your mic unmute, please keep yourself muted.
If you have to produce vertical effect, then this size will reverse. It will be 4 cross 6. So we will see one example. We will try to understand the construction of these wave 12s, horizontal wave 12s, with the help of an example on graph paper. Yes. So take a graph and select a size 6 cross 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 1, 2, 3, 4. 6 cross 4 is the size for design. And because your base 12 is 2 up down 12, so 4 cross 4 will be the pack plan or lifting plan. And your draft will be constructed on 6 cross 4. So this is size for draft 1, 2, 3, 4. here 6 and here 6. So this is place for draft, design and for lifting plan. So first we will construct design. So for construction of design, what we are doing? First, for construction of design, we have two methods. In first method, we can construct design first and then we can construct draft and lifting plan. In another method, second method, first we can construct draft and lifting plan, and with the help of draft and lifting plan, we can construct design. And the second method is easier method. So we will take first the lifting plan, and because our best twill, which we are taking as the base, regular twill, that is 2 up to down twill. So it can be, all of you know construction of a regular twill. So I'm constructing it 2 up, 2 down by counting number 1. Moving upward by 1, we have indicated a 2 up to down twill, which will be used as lifting plan for the construction of wave twill. Now here, this is number 1, 2, 3, and 4. So we will construct here a pointed draft. And pointed draft can be constructed by taking first end from first hill, second end from second hill, third end from third hill, fourth from fourth hill, and then we are reversing. So this will become the point of reversal, and then we will reverse the direction. So after fourth, third, after third, it is second. And automatically the next end will be passed through first hill frame, and that will become the point of reversal. So now here you have a draft, which is known as pointed draft. Here you have a lifting plan, which is 2 up to down twill. With the help of this draft and lifting plan, you can construct the design that you already know. So I will just take hill number 1. You will copy here, 2 up, 2 down. Then end number 2 is passing through hill number 2, and hill number 2 is 1 down, 2 up. So here 1 down, 2 up. End number 3 passing through hill number 3, and the working order is 2 down, 3 up, that we can see from lifting plan. And end number 4th, 1 up, 2 down, 1 up. Next end, 5th, passing through 3rd hill, that is 2 down, 2 up. It will be copied here. Next end, passing through 2nd hill frame, 1 down, 2 up. It will be copied here. And this design is known as waved twill. And this is a horizontal effect. If we tilt this at a 90 degree, it will be a vertical effect that you can construct. Similarly, you can take other examples, like if suppose instead of 2 up to down twill, you are taking 3 up, 3 down, then your size, that is 2n minus 2, 2 into, here it is, n is 6, 3 plus 3. So 2 into 6 minus 2, that is 10. So EPR is 10 and PPR is n, that is 6. So design will be constructed in 10 cross 6. Draft will be constructed in 10 cross 6. And lifting plan, that is 3 up 3 down twill, that will be constructed in 6 cross 6. And in the similar manner, you can construct design, draft and lifting plan for waved twill. Thank you.
Note down the page numbers. So students, I will try to understand the same topic with the help of this presentation. So modifications of twill, among the modification of twill, the first modification we are taking today is waved twill. And as I have explained in the video, these twills can be produced by reversing the direction of twill at a suitable point or suitable interval. So in the example of 6 cross 4, we have reversed on 4th end or 4th hill frame. Similarly, this point of reversal can be decided according to the size and requirement. The reversal may occur either upon an end, means vathrit, which results in a horizontal wave defect, or upon a peak, which results in a vertical wave defect. That I have already cleared during the video that if we are reversing the direction of twill on an end, or end ko hum center mante hain, or a particular end per jaka reverse karte hain, so it will result in a horizontal wave defect. Or agar hum end per nahi karke kisi particular peak per reverse karte hain, so ye peak wise reversal hoga, and that will be a vertical wave defect. The horizontal wave defect, which are symmetrical about the vertical axis, can be produced economically with pointed drafts. That is most important point for horizontal and vertical wave defects, because horizontal effects are symmetrical about the vertical axis, and whichever the design which are symmetrical about the vertical axis can be constructed with the aid of pointed draft, as I mentioned at the time of explanation of pointed draft, and that will give an advantage that less number of hills will be required. If the same design is constructed with straight draft, it will require almost twice the number of hill frames. So, and I have mentioned, as the hill frames are increasing, cost is increasing. So to produce economical effects, horizontal wave effects can be produced with pointed drafts. So for that, we are using pointed drafts. So less number of hills will be required, which will reduce the cost. And these can be produced by means of tapet shedding mechanism, because number of peaks will be limited within the range of tapets. So tapet shedding mechanisms can be used for horizontal wave defect. But vertical wave defects mostly require adobe shedding motion because of large number of peaks, because we are reversing it on a peak. So number of peaks will increase. Like for example, if you are taking 12 cross 6 horizontal effect, it means we require only 6 peaks and 6 hill frames. So it can be, it is in the range of tapet shedding mechanism. But if it is 6 cross 12 or 8 cross 14, like vertical effects, then because number of peaks has crossed the limit of tapet shedding mechanism, scope of tapet shedding mechanism, that's why we have to go for Dobie shedding mechanisms. So that's why generally we prefer horizontal wave defects due to two reasons, because number of hills required is less, and also it can be produced with tapet shedding mechanism. Due to these two reasons, we prefer horizontal wave defects over vertical effects. Method of construction shown in the video also. So here I'm again explaining the size, how we decide the size, because the and here we are taking the size particularly for horizontal wave defects. Just reverse will be the case for vertical effects. So I have not mentioned the size for vertical wave defects. You have to just reverse the size. EPR will become PPR and PPR will become EPR if you have to produce counterpart of horizontal effects. So EPR is, because it is based on pointed draft. So in pointed draft, we calculate EPR by taking formula 2N minus 2. So EPR will be equal to 2N minus 2 for wave twill also. And peaks per repeat will be always equal to N, where N is the number of threads or number of hill frames in the base twill or original twill. For example, if you are taking 2 up 2 down twill, number of threads or number of hills will be same. In regular twills, number of threads and number of hills means ends per repeat, peaks per repeat, and number of hill frames are always equal. So any number can be taken. So 2 up 2 down can be constructed with 4 ends or 4 peaks or 4 hills. So N will be 4 in that case. If it is 3 up 3 down twill, N will be 6. If it is 4 up 4 down twill, N will be 8. I'm taking all the examples of even-sided or balanced twills, because generally for the modifications of twill, we prefer balanced twills. So after deciding the size, second step is indicate a pointed draft as a draft in suitable size. Then we will do what? Size decide on the view. So on the graph, we have the size, the location of the view, the size, we will reserve there. And then just on the view, we will show draft. The size of the draft will be, because already you know the ends per repeat, and ends per repeat in the draft and ends per repeat in the design is same. So EPR will be same as we have calculated here, and here number of hills will be also N. So whatever the N we are taking, that will be the number of hill frames here. So in this way, your vertical spaces will be equal to EPR and horizontal spaces will be equal to number of field frames in the draft. So by taking this, we will first allocate the place of this draft just above the view in the same in the size, required size, and then indicate base twill as a lifting plan. जो भी base twill ले रहे हैं तो up down ले रहे हैं तो उसको आप lifting plan की जगह indicate करेंगे. Three up three down ले रहे हैं तो भी उसको lifting plan में indicate करेंगे. And size of lifting plan, vertical spaces are equal to number of field frames and horizontal spaces are equal to number of picks. So depending on the size of the design, original twill आप क्या ले रहे हैं उसके according ये सारी sizes आप calculate करेंगे. And then you will allocate their positions on the proper positions on the graph paper, and then we will start working. So here the same example which we have taken in video is shown here. It is base twill is two up two down twill, which is repeating in 4x4, four ends and four picks per repeat, and requires four hill frames. So wave twill will be constructed. EPR can be calculated by taking 2n minus 2. So n is 4, so we will place 4 in place of n. So 2 into 4 minus 2, you will get 6. And PPR equal to n, that is 4. So you have the ends per repeat and picks per repeat. So you can decide the size. Ends per repeat is 6 and picks per repeat is 4. So the wave will be constructed in 6x4. So first, take a size 6x4 here for design. Just above the design, 6x4 for the draft and 4x4 for the lifting plan. So according to the base twill, we have decided the size of design, draft and lifting plan. Now, I have mentioned in the video, there are two methods. You can construct directly the view and then draft. You can construct draft and lifting plan from given view. Another method is first you construct lifting plan, then draft. And with the help of lifting plan and draft, you can construct the view. Both the cases we have studied in details in basic concepts. So you can use either method. But as I have mentioned, the second method is more easy. So I have taken here lifting plan in two up two down twill. This two up two down twill can be constructed by any method, endwise method, pickwise method, or diagonal method. And then pointed draft, as I have mentioned in the construction of pointed draft, first, we move in a straight line from first to last hill frame. And the last hill frame is ending on fourth end. So this fourth end will become the point of reversal. Yeah, ek arrow maine show kiya, that is indicating that we are reversing the twill here. So yeah, hum twill ko reverse kar rahe hain. To reverse ka matlab, agar yahan tak hum straight gaye hain, left to right gaye hain, to hum right to left jayenge. Starting from here, we'll move towards left. And within the repeat, it will end on second hill frame. And that is the checking criteria for correct pointed draft. Last end must pass through second hill frame. So it is fulfilling the criteria. It means we have constructed a correct draft. Because you have taken a correct size and correct method, then you will get a correct draft. And with the help of this draft and lifting plan, you can construct the design as I have explained in video also, or in the some previous examples we have taken. If the draft and lifting plan is given, how we can construct design. If first method you have to use, then first take size for design and then indicate the base twill up to half of the design, up to the required size of the design. Base twill kitne mein hai? 4x4 mein hai. 1, 2, 3, 4 pe aap pehle 2 up to down twill design indicate kar dein. So is thread ko aap center thread le lein. अगर ये सेंटर थ्रेड है तो नेक्स्ट थ्रेड बिल्कुल सिमिलर होगा प्रीवियस के. प्रीवियस टू डाउन टू अप है तो यहाँ भी टू डाउन टू अप आएगा. फिर नेक्स्ट जो थ्रेड है वो सेम होगा इस थ्रेड के. दिस इज वन डाउन टू अप, तो वन डाउन टू अप यहाँ पे कॉपी होगा और ऑटोमेटिकली ये वापस नेक्स्ट रिपीट में आ जाएगा. इन दिस वे ऑल्सो यू कैन कंस्ट्रक्ट द डिजाइन. जब डिजाइन दिया हुआ है तो यू कैन कंस्ट्रक्ट ड्राफ्ट बाय पासिंग फर्स्ट एंड फ्रॉम फर्स्ट हिल, सेकंड फ्रॉम सेकंड, थर्ड फ्रॉम थर्ड, फोर्थ फ्रॉम फोर्थ, एंड comparing fifth with the previous one, it is same as this one. So from the third hill frame, this is same as this one. This is passing through second hill frame, so passing it through second hill frame, and simultaneously copying working order of ends on the in the lifting plan, you can construct lifting plan. So any one method you can use, whatever is easy for you. For me, first construction of draft and lifting plan and then construction of design is easier, so I prefer that method. but it depends on you what is easy for you that you can follow, because finally the result will be same. Another example, base 12, 3 up, 3 down. If you change the base 12, your size will change. EPR equal to 2 into 6 minus 2, that is 10. PPR will be N equal to 6, so 10 cross 6. Taking a size 10 cross 6 for design, 10 ends and 6 hills for draft, 10 cross 6. And lifting plan will be constructed in 6 cross 6. And 3 up, 3 down 12 will be indicated as the lifting plan. So we have indicated 3 up, 3 down 12. Pointed draft starting from first to last. And then last hill will become, this last thread will become a center point, and then reversal will take place. So left to right, we are moving in the first part, then we'll move right to left. Last end must pass to second hill frame, and that is fulfilled here. So draft is correct draft. By taking this as a draft, this as a lifting plan, you can construct a design that will be a wave 12, horizontal wave 12 in 10 cross 6. In all the horizontal 12s, EPR will be more than PPR. In vertical 12s, PPR will be more than EPR. But we found some different cases also for a wave 12. So in the previous methods, first what we are deciding, we are taking a base 12. It means we are having a particular number of hill frames, that is N. And with the help of N, we are calculating EPR by taking 2N minus 2. But sometimes in the examination, you may found construct a wave 12 in this size. So if the size is given, then you have to decide what will be the N, what will be the base 12, all this, all that exercise you have to do before starting the question. So if EP, the size is given, then first check the EP, because in the size you will find EPR and PPR, and we know PPR is equal to N. So you can find out N. And once you have find out N, then you can apply 2N minus 2 with that N. So if it fulfills the requirement of 2N minus 2, if EPR is equal to 2N minus 2, follow the previous methods given in the previous examples. But if EPR or PPR, EPR for horizontal effects and PPR for vertical effects, so if EPR is not equal to 2N minus 2, those examples are also there. For example, wave 12 in 12 cross 6 or 14 cross 6, 14 cross 8, make it 14 cross 8, or even 14 cross 6 can be also constructed. 12 cross 6 and 14 cross 6. Both are okay. So 12 cross 6, you can see here, N is 6. If you apply the formula 2N minus 2, what should be EPR? EPR kya hona chahiye?
10.
10, but it is not 10. It is 12. In another example, it is also not 10. It is 14. So it is not fulfilling the requirement. EPR is not equal to 2N minus 2. It means it is a different case. And we will change the method slightly. And what are the changes I am explaining here? Then point of reversal will change. Hum kya kar rahe the? Pehle hum view ko N par hi reverse kar rahe the. Jo view humne two up down base pe banayi hai, usko humne fourth par reverse kiya tha. जो हमने 3 अप 3 डाउन बनाया उसको हमने 6 पर रिवर्स किया था. रिमेंबर दिस पॉइंट, हम n पर ही रिवर्स कर रहे थे पहले, बट अभी हम n पर रिवर्स नहीं करेंगे क्योंकि EPR इज नॉट इक्वल टू 2n माइनस 2. सो हम कहां रिवर्स करेंगे, दैट वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट. सो पॉइंट ऑफ रिवर्सल POR विल चेंज. सो इंस्टेड ऑफ n, अज्यूम इट k, जस्ट टू डिफरेंशिएट टू अवॉइड द कंफ्यूजन, n की जगह आप पॉइंट ऑफ रिवर्सल को k अज्यूम कर ले. वहां क्योंकि n और पॉइंट ऑफ रिवर्सल सेम था इसलिए हमने n ही रखा था, बट यहाँ पर n अलग होगा और पॉइंट ऑफ रिवर्सल अलग होगा, इसलिए हमने पॉइंट ऑफ रिवर्सल को k से डिनोट किया है. एंड नाउ पुट इंस्टेड ऑफ n पुट k इन द फॉर्मूला, EPR इक्वल टू 2k माइनस 2. मैंने और कोई चेंज नहीं किया, n की जगह मैंने k रख दिया यहाँ पर. सो अब आप यहाँ पे k कैलकुलेट कर सकते हैं, बिकॉज यू नो द EPR. EPR गिवन है हमारे को, हमारे को पॉइंट ऑफ रिवर्सल पता नहीं है. तो हम पॉइंट ऑफ रिवर्सल पता करने के लिए क्या करेंगे, इस 2k माइनस 2 जो फॉर्मूला है उसमें से k की वैल्यू निकालने के लिए फॉर्मूले में चेंज कर देंगे, जो आप ट्रांसफर करके करते हैं. k इक्वल टू EPR, 2 इधर ट्रांसफर होगा तो माइनस से प्लस बनेगा, EPR प्लस 2. एंड यहाँ पर क्योंकि 2k है तो ये मल्टीप्लीकेशन में है तो ये डिनोमिनेटर में चला जाएगा. सो EPR प्लस 2 डिवाइडेड बाई 2. सो फॉर 12 क्रॉस 6 पॉइंट ऑफ रिवर्सल क्या होगा, k इक्वल टू EPR 12 है तो 12 plus 2 divided by 2, that is 7. So reversal will take place on 7th thread of the repeat instead of 6. And if it is 14 cross 6, here 12 की जगह 14 रखेंगे, you will get 8. It means for 14 cross 6, reversal will take place on 8th thread of the repeat. अगर आप 10 cross 6 ले रहे थे, तो 6 पे हो रहा था, 12 ले रहे हैं तो 7 पे होगा, और 14 ले रहे तो 8 पे होगा. Try to understand with the help of example. Here it is, 12 cross 6 size I have taken for design. Draft के लिए भी 12 cross 6 ही होगा, and lifting plan के लिए 6 cross 6 होगा. तो पहले 6 cross 6 में मैंने एक lifting plan बना दिया, 3 up 3 down 2 will indicate कर दिया. Same as the previous method जो हमने 10 cross 6 में लिया था, same as that we have taken here, 6 cross 6, 3 up 3 down 2 as the lifting plan. And here, first, now we have to construct draft, pointed draft as the draft. So starting from first heel frame, first peak, indicate the mark 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. कहाँ तक जाएंगे हम? Point of reversal क्या calculate किया हमने 12 cross 6 में?
7.
7. यानी कि 7th end will become center point. तो 7th end तक आपको straight जाना है. पहले हम 6th तक straight जा रहे थे, और 7th को हमने रिवर्स कर दिया था, बट अभी आपको 7th तक स्ट्रेट जाना है. तो जैसा कि क्लॉक में होता 1 टू 12 और 12 के बाद अगेन 1 आता है, यह हमारा लिमिटेशन 6 हिल तक है, क्योंकि हमारी नंबर ऑफ हिल 6 हैं, तो 1 2 3 4 5 6 तक हम गए हैं, और 6 के बाद नेक्स्ट एंड किससे पास होगा, नेक्स्ट हिल फ्रेम क्या होगा 6 के बाद?
1 से पास होगा,
1 होगा 6 के बाद, क्योंकि कोई नंबर ही नहीं, हमारा मैक्सिमम नंबर 6 है, तो अगला नंबर 1 आएगा. तो यानी कि 7th एंड को हम 1 से पास करेंगे. पहले हम यहीं से रिवर्स स्टार्ट कर रहे थे, अभी हम क्या करेंगे 7th एंड तक जाएंगे, और 1 टू 6 गए, 6 के बाद भी हम स्ट्रेट ही रखेंगे अप टू पॉइंट ऑफ रिवर्सल, स्ट्रेट जाएंगे. तो 7th एंड पर हम स्ट्रेट जाएंगे, इसका मतलब हम 7th एंड को फर्स्ट से पास करेंगे, क्योंकि 6 के बाद नॉर्मल ऑर्डर में 1 आता है, इसलिए हमने 1 से पास किया. एंड देन रिवर्स, ये सेंटर बन गया, तो सेंटर से इस तरफ वाला एंड 6 से पास हो रहा है, तो ये भी 6 से पास होगा, उसका प्रीवियस एंड 5th से, तो ये भी 5th से, तो 6 5 4 3 2 एंड यू कैन सी लास्ट एंड इज पासिंग थ्रू सेकंड हिल फ्रेम. इट मींस दिस इज अ करेक्ट पॉइंटेड ड्राफ्ट. नाउ बाय टेकिंग दिस एज अ पॉइंटेड ड्राफ्ट, दिस एज अ लिफ्टिंग प्लान, यू कैन कंस्ट्रक्ट द डिजाइन. अ डिफेक्ट ऑफ द पॉइंटेड 12 is the formation of an increased float where the wave turns. And disadvantage is associated with this waved 12, that is a defect of pointed 12 is the formation of an increased float where the wave turns. जहां भी wave turn होती है, वहां पर एक increased float बनता है. एक weft का जो float, weft का या warp का जो float बनता है, वो बाकी float से उसकी length ज्यादा होती है. And that's why it looks like a defect in the fabric. That is a disadvantage of the structure of waved twills. Long floats occur in the weft in horizontal effects and in the warp in the vertical effects. ये मैं आपको clear करता हूँ example से. आप देखिए यहाँ पर, यहाँ आप देखिए weft wise, ये horizontal effect, इसलिए weft wise float देखिए, ये 3 का है, ये 3 का है, 1 2 3 है. यहाँ भी आप देखेंगे 3 3 के floats बन रहे हैं, बट जहां रिवर्सल हो रहा है वहां पर आप देखिए एक लॉन्ग फ्लोट बन रहा है, 1 2 3 4 5, यानी कि ये जो वेफ्ट है 5 टाइम्स फ्लोट कर रहा है, जो कि बाकी फ्लोट्स की लेंथ से अलग है. इट इज सिमिलर, यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड इन अ सिमिलर मैनर, कि ज्यादातर कोई एक ग्रुप खड़ा है स्टूडेंट्स का, और उसमें ज्यादातर की लेंथ सपोज 5 फीट 6 इंच है, बट वहां पर अगर 6 फीट का स्टूडेंट खड़ा है तो एकदम से वहां पे ओड लगेगा. सिमिलरली हियर, अगर सारे फ्लोट्स ठीक है बट एक फ्लोट अगर ज्यादा लेंथ का आ रहा है, तो इट विल लुक लाइक एज अ डिफेक्ट, एंड दैट इज अ डिसएडवांटेज एसोसिएटेड वेव ट्विल व्हिच वी हैव टेकन इन दिस स्लाइड. नोट डाउन योर असाइनमेंट, आज से आप असाइनमेंट इसमें स्लाइड में दे रहा हूँ, ताकि आपको याद भी रहे, मुझे भी याद रहेगा, और आज से आप करना स्टार्ट कर दें. पहले भी मैंने कुछ दिए, उनको कम्प्लीट करें, और फिर इससे करें आप. फर्स्ट इज कंस्ट्रक्ट अ वेव ट्विल इन 14 क्रॉस 8, जो कि मैंने आपको एक्सप्लेन किया था 14 क्रॉस 6 वाला, आपको 14 क्रॉस 8 में बनाना है इसको. 14 क्रॉस 8 मींस 2n माइनस 2 कितना हुआ, 14. इट मींस आप यहां पर, आपको पॉइंट ऑफ रिवर्सल शिफ्ट करने की जरूरत नहीं है. आई हैव टेकन अ वेरी सिंपल एग्जांपल. जो फर्स्ट एग्जांपल हमने लिए उसी की तरह आपको करना है. इन कंस्ट्रक्ट वेव टूल इन 6x10, यहाँ आपको वर्टिकल वेव टूल बनाना है. ये हॉरिजॉन्टल इफेक्ट हो गया क्योंकि यहाँ पर ईपीआर ज्यादा है, ये वर्टिकल इफेक्ट हो गया क्योंकि यहाँ पे पीपीआर ज्यादा है. तो यहाँ पर जो रिवर्सल होगा वो 6th पीक पर जाकर के होगा. एंड वर्टिकल इफेक्ट्स के लिए हम पॉइंटेड ड्राफ्ट यूज नहीं कर सकते हैं, उसके लिए स्ट्रेट ड्राफ्ट यूज होगा और पेक प्लान विल बी सेम एज डिजाइन. इन दिस वे यू कैन कंस्ट्रक्ट एनी टाइप ऑफ इफेक्ट्स हॉरिजॉन्टल एंड वर्टिकल एंड एनी गिवन साइज फॉर वेव ट्वेल्स. Still, we have 1 minute. So, if you have any question, you can ask. Pardon?
Since sir, you are not audible. Order क्या लेना है?
क्या?
Sir, 14x8 और sir इसमें interlacement order क्या लेना है?
14x8 या जो भी है, जो second number है, जो smaller number है, वो आपको number of fields बताता है. अगर 8 है, तो उसमें कौन सा twill आएगा? 8 hills में कौन सा ट्विल आएगा?
4 up 4 down.
But it is not essential कि आप हमेशा wave ट्विल के अंदर भी हमेशा हम balance ट्विल लें. आप 5 up 3 down भी ले सकते हैं, 3 up 5 down भी ले सकते हैं, 6 up 2 down भी ले सकते हैं, 2 up 6 down भी ले सकते हैं, 7 up 1 down भी ले सकते हैं, 1 up 7 down भी ले सकते हैं. Any interlacing order suitable in 8 hill frames can be taken as the interlacing order. That you have to decide. अगर साइज गिवन है तो इंटरलेसिंग ऑर्डर आपको डिसाइड करना है. एनी अदर क्वेश्चन? ओके, सो दिस इज फर्स्ट मॉडिफिकेशन वी हैव कवर्ड, वेव ट्विल, पॉइंटेड ट्विल और जिग.